Probably need to have the stage here. Stage would have been alright. Alright. I don't know this place. I guess making the stage would have been tricky.
Alright, bye.
Moving on. Will Hasbro be having a mail order pony points program again?
Because we know all these collectors out here love their pony points.
We don't have plans at this time for pony points, and I must say, I did not see a single pony cross here this year. Every other year I've seen another pony cross here somewhere. Does anyone have them? Did I miss it? No?
They're all protected at home.
Yeah, one's outside my office, just so you all know.
Why don't ponies have cutie marks or symbols on both sides of their bodies?
Very good question. So in this show, all the ponies do actually have a cutie mark on each side of their body, as many of you might know. But in production, we only put it on one side of the pony's body when we make it onto toys. And fun fact for all of you, it's always the side of the pony's body that faces out in the package. So if you ever get home and you wonder why everyone's cutie marks on one side versus the other, it would have been the one that was facing front when they were in back.
Okay. Interesting. So do we plan on releasing any more G1 ponies?
There are no plans for G1 sculpts at this time. However, a lot of you probably know some of our old favorites like Applejacks have now been written into the show. She has come back in her new form, so we're certainly open to taking some of our old favorites, incorporating those characters into the new generation of Final Pony.
And along those same lines, will there be any new art ponies?
There are no plans for art ponies. Sorry.
Will there be any exclusives targeted towards collectors and not bronies? For example, many would love more G1 through G3 ponies, or even ponies in the G1 mold, or even art ponies like Venus Answer that part. So, any other collector ponies?
So the plan at the moment isn't to elaborate that much more in our collector segment. As many of you know, we have the collector pony who's available for our fairs and conventions this year. This is a reminder, she will be going up on Hasbro Toy Shop after Comic-Con, so keep your eyes peeled. We also have a new collector segment that's available exclusively at Toys R Us this fall, so you can certainly find a nice mix of core ponies as well as new ponies in those sets. And last but not least, we'll be using our drawing bags and our miniature collectibles to drive that collectible and make sure we put as many characters in there as possible. So if you're looking for a rare, hard-to-find character that will be in the future, make sure to keep your eyes on the blind bags and the links that are coming.
Wow, that makes those blind bags really exciting. And for those that haven't come up and seen this new Toys R Us pack, there's some really cool stuff in there.
And it's available for Apple. This is not coming home with me today.
Is that my pocket? No, I don't think it is. Good. I don't know if I have it. So. Will the collector's line continue to have two exclusives a year, or can we expect to only see one pony like this year?
We can't speak yet for 2013. Those plans actually aren't in place yet. But what I can say is we try to find the right opportunities for the collector pony and the one that will be the most appealing. And I think I can say with some confidence that we hit it out of the park this year. So looking to make sure we're going to maximize that and make it everyone.
Yeah, I think a lot of these people are really excited about that Princess Celestia and White. Okay, now we're going to get into some G4 specific questions. And this is one I think we probably get asked every year now. Will we ever see G4 Minty as a regular release? The few that showed up online were so cute, I want one. I didn't know that.
We actually don't have plans in 2012 for Minty as a regular release, but I do happen to hear from someone who's much closer to the product than I am to say, keep your eyes on the blind bags, whatever that means.
That's kind of an oxymoron, right? Eyes on the blind bag. Moving on. Are we getting Wave 2 blind bags in the U.S., or is it really skipping to Wave 3? There's a big long reference line in this question, which
I did look that up earlier. We aren't skipping waves of blind bags. This is wave 2. It's here today, and I have it in front of me today. It means it's sitting in my Hasbro warehouse somewhere because I ordered it to bring here. One lucky winner will get the entire set of 24 out of the raffle today. They should be following closely behind me to a retailer near you.
tackles over here really cool to get all this stuff, especially a full set of those linebackers. So tell me about the Crystal Empire series.
So I am not allowed to tell anyone about the Crystal Empire series. We had to reach out to our partners over the studio, and we were told that we can't share at this time, but I'm claiming that there is some more exciting news coming from them very soon.
Hey, at least we know there's something called Crystal Empire. Will there be any stallions besides shining armor?
The only stallion this year is shining armor in the access set. However, there are warrior boy ponies scattered throughout some more of the line. So we have ponies in our collector series as well as in the line bags. And beyond Fallout 12, we do know the popularity of the boy ponies. So stay tuned.
Exciting. Will there be any new pony poses for the brushable ponies this year?
There will not be new poses this year, but as we are looking into next year to incorporate new characters and new personalities into the brushables, we are exploring the opportunities where those make little sense.
I like that news. About the gift set that included molded hair versions of Princess Celestia, Twilight Sparkle, Applejack, and Peekie Pie. Will our other Friendship is Magic friends, Riri, Rainbow, and Dash, and Fluttershy, ever get molded hair versions too?
They will not for 2012. That molded hair set was actually done right before we launched the new look of Pony. It was the first set that ever came out with the Friendship is Magic look, so it was a great launch for us and on to the entertainment. But now that those characters are alive and well and on TV all the time, we are planning to pursue the brushable hair other than in the smaller scale.
Girls do like that brushable hair. I should see all the problems my wife has around my house. Are there any plans to release any other baddies or villains? Like Nightmare Moon, Discord, or the Challenging Queen?
Changeling.
What about a minion?
Bad, 12 minutes so far.
Can we blame that on Nightmare Moon or on Discord?
Discord!
So you're the winner. There. Security!
So we're incredibly excited about how positive the response has been to Nightmare Moon and our PRU set for fall. And just as a quick nod to all our friends at toysrus.com, it is available for pre-order now. So get on there and look it up. But we cannot say
So how is it decided which movies will be international exclusives? Well, like Star Swirl, Rainbow Flash, and Skywishers. Okay, we're back. The tech support over here, so we can use my mic the next time. You want to refresh on that question?
No, no, I think I'm all set.
All right.
I'm excited for which will be international exclusives.
Yeah.
Okay. So just give you all a little glimpse into the life of product development at Hasbro. We actually don't make items that are international exclusives. We actually make an entire portfolio of the best pony products throughout the world. Market, be it the US or Canada or Europe, has very different needs. So we kind of go through, if you will, and make our shopping list of which items are going to perform the best with our market. And that's how you end up with certain products that maybe in the US and not elsewhere, or maybe elsewhere and not in the US. And we're certainly looking for the best opportunities here in our market. As many of you know, blind bags are a great example. Those are available in
check. I'm going to hit buttons until it works. Right. Are you going? You're not? Okay, let me get together with him.
Just go over by her. Yeah, just stand together.
Good to see these microphones working again. For now. Will the blind bags have brushable versions?
We are not putting brushable versions just because I tend to take a teeny pony that small and put a root hair in it.
sort of did them last year with the Valentine Pinkie Pie and Spring Fluttershy, but we didn't do any Halloween or Christmas or Valentine's or Easter 2012. Any chance of releasing those holiday ponies again?
We are not updating the holiday ponies at this time, unfortunately. So there are still Spring Fluttershy, which you all are not into. We also have a winter version. It just doesn't get it wrong.
Okay. Right again.
It takes just a second to see if we can get a good swap out of the
time.
And the suspense is in this last question. Are there any plans to make playsets of the homes? Like Sweet Apple Acres, Fluttershy's Treehouse, Sugar Cube Corner, Dolls of Pumpkin Cake and Pound Cake?
As you all know, playsets are a huge part of My Little Pony and play and the way all of our consumers think with the brand. So we took our first nod this fall to take the wedding castle and make that into a real life environment to play out the wedding episode. So in the future, there are certainly plans to continue to use the environment from the show to make more play spaces for all the characters. So I would say for 12, we're really kicking this off with castle, with the only place you can get shiny armor. And then going into next year, stay tuned for more.
All right. And remember, if you want to be the first person to have that pony castle and shining armor, the raffle's right over there. Tickets, $6 for $5, $1 for $1. All right, we want to thank our friends here from Hasbro for this great Q&A. They're open to answer any more questions. If you all come up and ask them as the day goes on, they will be here. And they are happy and love to have us all here to talk to us.